My name is Mark Manders, and I was born in Volkel in Holland. It's a very small town in the middle of Holland. Yeah, I have a studio in Holland, in Arnhem, and in Ronse in Belgium. Yeah, I studied graphic design, but when I was 18, I wanted to be a writer. And then, it's maybe a long story, but what basically happened is that I started writing with objects instead of with words, and that became my job. Yeah, I at that time when I was 18, I just maybe that's a good word for this show. I felt really kind of alien in the world. Like I felt like I was really focused on things like I was wondering why I was wearing shoes. Because I thought, like, in terms of evolution, it's very strange that people wear shoes. Like, it's not logical, because like since humans start wearing shoes, the feet became very weak, and also the same is with my teeth. If I don't brush my teeth, they become very weak, and so I was really thinking a lot about evolution, about objects, how objects relate to the human body. And. And at that time, I really wanted to write a self-portrait. I wanted to write a book that was an ongoing book, and I wanted to write about it for the rest of my life. But then I made a floor plan, and it was in '86, and I decided to write for the rest of my life about this floor plan, and things happening in this floor plan. And there were like seven characters living in this fictionary building. And I just wanted to write about that, but then I just realized that it was better to write not with words, but with objects, with real things that are really in the world. And that's what I'm doing now. Yeah, it's called Self-Portrait as a Building, and it's it became like a kind of machine that tells me what to do. I don't, of course I make all the decisions, but like if I make one work, this work tells me what the next work will be, and it's like it's a very logical construction in a way. Similar than the world is also very logical. It's very logical that we have roads, so that objects can come to the supermarket, and that we have thick roads and thin roads, and so in a way, like this building that I make is organized the same way as the real world. Like a piece of thread can come into a shop in China, or comes from China to just a small place in America. Like it's really well organized. It's really amazing, actually. And I really want to copy this thing into a fictionary world. If viewers see my work, they can try to construct somebody who they think that made all these works. And I think if they do that, it will tell them something about themselves. More about themselves than about me, because their thoughts that they are making about me. Yeah, most of the time the figurative works are like made of clay. But actually, they look like they're made of clay, but they're made of bronze or other materials. But they're painted like wet clay. And I think that's sometimes I also make figures of sand. And I think clay and sand are like very fundamental things to work with. If you make a figure, it's very logical to make it of clay. And I want these objects I want them to look like they are just left behind. For example, in this show, I have a piece of 1992 and a piece of last week, 2008. And they both look that they are just made a day ago or something like that. They're just freshly made. And I really like that. I want to create with my work like one big super moment, like that everything is just made just been made, you know? It's like I really want to create a really great standstill, like, I have the feeling that I make all my works at the age of 18. Also sometimes the materials that I use are from the mid-80s, and sometimes I have to remake things of the mid-80s because they don't exist anymore. But I, and it has nothing to do with being nostalgic or something, but it's just something I really wanted that I made all my work really and only in that period. I don't know why. It's like an age that I was really that everything fell together, like that I understood how I worked and what I wanted to do in my life, and how the world is organized, and how you as a person are set into the history of mankind, and how you can use that. So I really would like to, but it takes me many years to make all these works. But it's like one big super moment. Yeah, I think you know, sometimes I was in shows like, for example, Documenta 11. And it was a show that I really liked, and I felt like I was the alien in that show. Like I had the feeling that I was that they showed me as a person who, like, maybe something like, see here you have a person who makes this. This is a human being, and he makes this kind of things. And so I think in this show I'm more like, maybe more surrounded with other aliens. So yeah, I feel very comfortable. But I also felt comfortable in Documenta, because but it's a very different context, and I like that my work, in a way my work always stays the same, but in every show it has a different context, and I really enjoy that. And I also learn a lot about that. It's not only like you know, my work is different in my studio than when it's placed in the real world. You know, my work is not my work is site specific, but in a way I always see my exhibitions as kind of reproductions of rooms that exist somewhere else. So it's. Of course, like for every show, I have a kind of goal, and you know, when I receive the sizes of a room and I get photographs, I'm really thinking about this existing place, but I also have to deal with this imaginary space where it's so it's really complicated. But what I really like also about shows is that you have a deadline. For example, one piece that I feel, the biggest piece, I started, I think, 2 years ago, and I never felt like finishing it. And I just 2 months ago, I thought like, shit, now is the moment to finish it. And that's really good. So I really also enjoy deadlines. Yeah, like in my studio, it's really like a huge playground. Maybe I have something like 20 works that I'm working on, and they're all over, scattered all over my studio. I have lots of rooms there, and I just the whole day I'm just walking around, and sometimes if I don't know what to do, I start to clean up, and it never works. I never clean up, but I start cleaning up, and then I move something, and then while I move, I'm thinking, and then something happens, and I just start working. So actually my studio is quite a mess, but I try to clean it up every time, but it doesn't happen. No, actually when my studio is empty, totally empty, then actually it's always great, because I just started filling it up, and it's you know, it's something you cannot stop. It's kind of I think most of the artists have it, like it's very addictive to to create new things that 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 nobody's asking for, and that that it's something, yeah, something so great to do, you know. It's